A veteran takes his hat off during the Remembrance Sunday Cenotaph wreath-laying ceremony. Reuters members of the Western Front Association during a service at the Cenotaph to mark the Armistice Day E. P.A. David Davis and Michelle Barnier, Reuters, Britain's newly appointed Secretary of State for International Development. Penny Mordaunt leaves Downing Street app. Priti Patel leaves number 10 Downing Street through the back entrance. EPA school children and their teacher from Thomas Tallis School look at pictures on display at the Red Star Over Russia exhibition at the Tate Modern in London. Philip Tuscano parade cast of the wrestlers, two men taking part in the Greek sport pancration, is lowered into place at Natural Trust Stowe Landscape Garden near Buckingham, PA. Protesters in Trafalgar Square, London. During the Million Mass March Bonfire Night protest, PA protesters take part in the Justice Now Make It Right for Palestine march, organized by the Palestine Solidarity Campaign, in central London. PA people queue outside an Apple store in London to purchase the new iPhone X upon its release in the UK. The iPhone X is positioned as a high-end model intended to showcase advanced technologies such as wireless charging, OLED display, dual cameras and a face recognition unlock system. Getty. British Prime Minister Theresa May greets Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu outside 10 Downing Street in London. The pair are today celebrating the centenary of a British declaration that ultimately led to the foundation of the State of Israel. Getty. Mammatus clouds over St. Mary's Lighthouse in Whitley Bay, Northumberland. Owen Humphreys per women protest outside Downing Street as they join a demonstration demanding rights for working mothers. Getty images. England under-17s pose with a World Cup trophy as they arrive back to the UK. PA Leicester City Remembrance Day fixture between Leicester City and Everton at King Power Stadium. Plum images. Leicester City FC via Getty images. Spider-Man steals a seat on the Iron Throne from Game of Thrones at MCM. London Comic Con's opening day. Rex features. British fashion designer Vivienne Westwood holds up a paper against the government's policy on fracking outside Downing Street in London. At Getty, members of a delegation of indigenous and rural community leaders from 14 countries in Latin America and Indonesia, the Guardians of the Forest campaign, demonstrate against deforestation in London during a stop on the way to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change UNFCCC conference of the parties 23 COP23 in Bonn, Germany. Tolga Ackman. At Getty, Gemma Davis, 23, cleans the Doll's House during its annual clean at the National Trust's Cork Abbey property, in Ticknell, Derbyshire. The Doll's House was used by the family's various generations of children between 1860 and the Second World War in their schoolroom. PA Prince William and Kate chat with West Ham player Mark Noble and manager Slaven Bilic during the Coach Corps graduation ceremony. Getty images. Jellyfish wash up on Sidmouth Beach after Storm Ophelia hit the UK. Getty images. A red sun appears in mid Wales before Storm Ophelia hits Paul Williams. Alamy Live News. The Duchess of Cambridge dances with Paddington Bear as they attend a charities forum event at Paddington train station in London on October 16, 2017. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry join children from the charities they support on board Belmond British Pullman train at Paddington station. The event was hosted by STUDIOCANAL, with support from BAFTA through its BAFTA Kids program, and before embarking their Royal Highnesses met the cast and crew from the forthcoming film Paddington 2. At Getty images. Large waves crash along sea defences and the harbour as Storm Ophelia approaches Porthleven in Cornwall, southwest Britain. Reuters. Hillary Clinton gives a speech as she is presented with a honorary doctorate of law at Swansea University in Swansea, Wales. The former US Secretary of State and 2016 American presidential candidate is also visiting the UK to promote her new book, What Happened. Matthew Horwood. Getty. A lone protester demonstrates outside Workman Quadrilla's shale gas fracking drilling rig near Westby in Blackpool. Engineers have begun to build the new rig at the site off Preston New Road in preparation for extracting gas. The site will be the first in the UK to extract shale gas since 2011. Getty photographs of missing Syrians are displayed as people, including a group of Syrian women, stand atop a double-decker bus during a demonstration by Families for Freedom in Parliament Square in London. Getty workmen erect scaffolding around the Elizabeth Tower, commonly known called Big Ben, during ongoing renovations to the tower and the Houses of Parliament at Getty. An order of service is carried ahead of the funeral service for Coronation Street actress Liz Dawn, real name Sylvia Ann Ebertson, outside Salford Cathedral. A former Woolworths shop girl from Leeds, who first set foot on Weatherfield's famous cobbles in 1974, Dawn, who had four children, DPC last week at home with her family around her. PA Melanie Kramers of Oxfam poses while wearing a mask of Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson, with assorted props used in political campaigns, in the storeroom at Oxfam's headquarters in London. The props have all been used in the charity's campaigns over the years to raise awareness of issues affecting people in poverty. Today marks 75 years since Oxfam's founding in the middle of the Second World War. Getty: a visitor poses in front of an artwork by Czech Republic artist Anna Hulakova entitled Ascension Mark I during a photo call for the Frieze Art Fair in London at Getty. Britain's Chancellor of the Exchequer Philip Hammond arrives to speak at the Conservative Party's conference in Manchester. Reuters: Shanna Mackay. Protesters holding flags and placards demonstrate along Oxford Street during the annual Ashura March in London. Thousands of protesters march through London today to mark Ashura and celebrate the defeat of the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Ashura is a Muslim festival of remembrance that falls on the 10th day of Muharram in the Islamic calendar. Jack Taylor. Getty protesters hold up placards during the London March for Choice, calling for the legalising of abortion in Ireland after the referendum announcement, outside the Embassy of Ireland in central London. Chris J. Ratcliffe. Former UKIP leader Paul Nuttall C. speaks with delegates at the UKIP annual conference being held at the Riviera International Centre in Torquay. Macardy. Getty England and West fans enjoy themselves during the fourth Royal London One Day International between England and West Indies at the Kier Oval in London. Mike Hewitt. Getty Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn takes photographs during Shadow Secretary of State for Business, Energy and Industrial Strategy Rebecca Long Bailey's speech in the main hall on day three of the annual Labour Party conference in Brighton. Dan Kitwood. Getty images: naked bathers enter the water as they take part in the northeast skinny dip at Druridge Bay in Druridge, England. The popular annual event takes place around the autumn equinox at Druridge Bay as the sun rises. Participant registration fees have been pledged to the mental health charity Mind. Getty Rollo Morfling. Our crew at of Stonehenge and Britain are conducts a ceremony as druids, pagans and revelers gather in the centre at Stonehenge, hoping to see the sunrise, as they take part in a autumn equinox celebrations at the ancient Neolithic monument of Stonehenge near Amesbury in Wiltshire, England. Several hundred people gathered at sunrise are the famous historic Stone Circle, a UNESCO-listed ancient monument, to celebrate the equinox, which is a specific moment in time that occurs twice a year when the Earth tilts neither towards summer or away winter from the sun in either the northern or southern hemisphere. Although yesterday marked the actual meteorological calendar change from summer to autumn, for Druids, the following dawn is when they celebrate the dawning of the new season following the day of equal night, which it is named after. Getty. Britain's Prime Minister Theresa May delivers her Brexit speech at the Complesso Santa Maria Novella in Florence, Italy. British Prime Minister Theresa May will seek to unlock Brexit talks on September the 22nd, after Brussels demanded more clarity on the crunch issues of budget payments and EU citizens' rights. AFP people protest against the actions of the Spanish government in front of the Spanish consulate in Edinburgh. Spanish police stormed ministries and buildings belonging to Catalonia's regional government yesterday, in an attempt to try and put a stop to the region's independence referendum. Pep Massa Palomí. One of the final 55-meter turbine blades is maneuvered into position. The last of 116 wind turbines have been installed at the Rampion offshore wind farm 13 km off the Brighton coast. It will provide enough electricity to supply the equivalent of half the homes in Sussex. Mike Hewitt. Getty images: an armed police officer patrols in Horse Guards parade in London. an 18-year-old man has been arrested in Dover in connection with yesterday's terror attack on Parsons Green Station in which 30 people were injured. The UK terror threat level has been raised to critical. Jack Taylor Getty images demonstrators hold banners during a protest to lobby MPs to guarantee the rights of EU citizens living in the UK, after Brexit. Outside the Houses of Parliament, Tolga Akmanara, Rupert van der Werf, Summer Place Auctions natural history specialist, moves a one-year-old baby mammoth skeleton at Summer's Place Auctions on September 12, 2017 in Billingshurst. A family of four mammoths, found together during building works near the Siberian city of Tomsk in 2002, will be on sale on November 21, 2017, and are expected to sell in the region of £250,000, £400,000. Rob Stothargety images members of the Royal Navy carry supplies on board the amphibious assault ship HMS Ocean at the naval base in Gibraltar before leaving to provide humanitarian assistance and vital aid to British overseas territories and Commonwealth partners affected by Hurricane Irma. Britain has pledged £32 million, €35 million, $42 million in aid and sent hundreds of troops, supplies and rescue equipment on several flights to the British territories in the Caribbean since the disaster. Jorge Guerrero at Getty Images.